This video is to help you to see how the formulas for the volume of prisms and cylinders works. I want you to be able to see that it's all going to be the same basic idea. Now, there's these two opposite sides are congruent, and these two opposite sides are congruent, these opposite faces, and these two are going to be congruent to each other. So they're all going to be treated the same as far as their formulas are concerned. It's going to be the area of those bases times the height of the figure. They're all going to have the same formula, volume equals the big B base, area of your base, times the height of the figure. You already know the area of a rectangle is going to be length times width, and we're going to multiply that times height. That gives you a formula, length times width times height. You've heard that one before. But now you've learned that the area of a rectangle is base times height. Now you have two heights there. That doesn't make a lot of sense. So I'm going to change this. You won't see this anywhere else, but I'm going to go ahead and change this height to a capital H. My new formula becomes base times height of the rectangular base times the height of the entire figure. So I'm doing the area of that rectangle right there times the height. And the height could be any of these, what's called lateral edges, these perpendicular edges that go straight up from the base. Now let's try the triangular prism. It's also going to have a base and a height just for the triangle. And you know that's 1/2 base times height for that area times the height of the whole figure. So again, I'm going to change that to a capital H. So now our formula is going to be 1/2 base times height for the area of my base times the height of the total figure. And any of those edges can give you the height of that triangular prism. The same is going to be true for a cylinder. It's still going to be the area of the base, that's a circle, times the height of the cylinder. And you do pi times the radius squared times that height. And it comes out looking like that. That's how the formula will always be written. But just to keep it straight with all of my other ones, I'm going to go ahead and make it a capital H. Again, you won't see that anywhere else, but just to keep everything the same, I'm going to make a capital H there. Now this is true no matter what the orientation is, no matter how it's rotated, we're still going to have the same formula, area base times height. These can be rotated any way around. So there's the triangular prism, and there's our cylinder. Let's go ahead and rotate that around. And you're going to use the same formula. Now pay attention to what the bases are. Now here I'm going to go ahead and make the bottom the base again. Length times width times height. Again, length times width isn't what we use. We use base times height. So I'll make that a capital H so we can have that perpendicular to that bottom base. And again, we have base times height, 1/2 base times height for our triangular base. And now the height of the prism is down there. Now we still have the radius and the same height. Notice that the height, I'm going to go ahead and make it a big H, is going to be there. So the orientation doesn't matter. How it's rotated doesn't matter. The bases are still going to be these figures here that are parallel and congruent to each other. And there's going to be that, the height. Now, rectangles are a little bit easier. They're different in that the base can be anything. We can have the base at the bottom there, but I could have the base anywhere else because I have parallel congruent rectangles on all the sides. I could have my base here, then that would be the height. I could also have my base here in the front, and then that's going to be my height. It's always going to be perpendicular to the base. And any of those, what's called lateral edges, those would represent the height of the total prism. Again, pay attention to the other ones. They have to use those congruent figures as the bases. So later on, we will plug in numbers and use algebra. But right now, just remember it's area of the base times 100.